Welcome to a lesson on the probability of the union of two events. And just for a quick review, remember the probability compares the favorable number of outcomes to the total number of outcomes. And we've seen this in several of the previous slides. Let's go and take a look at the probability of a union. So to determine the probability of a union of two events, we'll have to follow this rule where the probability that the event E1 or E2 will occur is equal to the probability that E1 will occur plus the probability that E2 will occur, and then minus the probability that E1 and E2 will occur. So you might be asking why we have this subtraction here on the end. When we find the sum of these two probabilities, we may be counting successful outcomes twice. Therefore, by subtracting the probability of E1 and E2, we will only count the successful events once, which is what we need to do. I think when we take a look at an example, it'll be much more clear. If you roll two dice at the same time, determine each probability. What is the probability that the sum is 6 or a pair of odd numbers? Well, let's go ahead and call the sum of 6 event 1. And then a pair of odd numbers, event 2. So the probability of event 1 or event 2 is going to be equal to the probability of event 1 plus the probability of event 2 minus the probability of event 1 and event 2. The sample space for rolling two dice is listed here. There are 36 possible outcomes. Let's see if we can highlight the ones that have a sum of 6 to determine the probability of E1. Here's a 1 and a 5, 2 and a 4, 3 and a 3, 4 and a 2, and 5 and a 1. These are the successful events for having a sum of 6. So the probability of E1 would be 5 out of 36. Again, 36 being the total sample space. Plus, now we want to determine the probability of having a pair of odd numbers. And these we'll underline in green. So we have a 1 and a 1, a 1 and a 3, a 1 and a 5. Well, this column starts with a 2, so those won't work. So we'll jump to this column. There's a 3 and a 1, 3 and a 3, 3 and a 5. Now we'll jump to the column starting with 5. Here we have a 5 and a 1, a 5 and a 3, and a 5 and a 5. So there are 3, 6, 9 successful outcomes to have a pair of odd numbers. So the probability of event 2 would be 9 over 36. Now let's take a look at what we did here. Notice that there are 1, 2, 3 outcomes that were counted twice because they're both highlighted and underlined in green. We don't want to count those events twice, and that's why we have to subtract the probability of having a sum of 6 and having a pair of odd numbers, which we have here, which would be the 1 and the 5, the 3 and the 3, and the 5 and the 1. So we have to subtract 3 over 36, and this will give us the probability of having a sum of 6 or a pair of odd numbers. Looks like we'll have a numerator of 14 minus 3, so that would be 11 over 36. So this illustrates why we do have to subtract the probability of event 1 and event 2. Let's take a look at one more example of this. We're going to use a standard deck of cards for this question. We want to know what the probability of selecting one card that is red or a face card. So we'll call the red event 1, and we'll call the face card event 2. So the probability of event 1 or event 2, remember or means union, is going to equal the probability of event 1 plus the probability of event 2 minus the probability of event 1 and event 2. So for all these probabilities, there's going to be 52 possible outcomes because there are 52 cards. So we're going to have something over 52 plus something over 52 minus something over 52. So this first probability is the probability that selecting one card that is red. Well, half of the deck is red because half are either hearts or diamonds. So that would be 26 over 52. Event 2 is selecting a face card. Well, the face cards are the jacks, queens, and kings. And there's 4 jacks, 4 queens, and 4 kings. So that would be 12 over 52 minus the probability of the card being red and a face card. Well, there's 12 face cards, and half of them would be red. So this would be minus 6 over 52. Again, the reason we're doing this is we counted the red face cards here and here. So we counted them twice. So we must subtract them out once to only count them once. So this probability would be 26 plus 12, that's 38, minus 6, that would be 32 over 52. And these both have a common factor of 4. So this is equal to 8 thirteenths. I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.